Hello everyone, how are you all? Okay, so today we'll do a revision of Ind AS 10. Are you ready? So Ind AS 10, what is the name of Ind AS 10? Event occurring after reporting date. Events occurring after reporting date, correct? What is the corresponding AS? AS4. What was the name of AS4? Contingencies and event occurring after balance date. Now I think you have understood that in Ind AS we use the term reporting date. Reporting date. Now, the very small Ind AS, let us do revision quickly. So I think you have understood that if this is the reporting date and this is the date of approval of financial statement, date of approval of financial statement by whom? By board of director. So any event which occur during this period are known as event occurring after balance sheet date or event occurring after reporting date. So what is the meaning of event occurring after reporting date? Are those events which are favorable or unfavorable? Means it might be favorable to entity, it might be unfavorable to entities, and which occur between reporting date and the date when financial statement are approved for what? Issue. The word is what? When financial statement are approved for issue. So can I say financial statement are approved for issue by whom? When it is signed by whom? Signed by board of directors. Signed by board of directors. Correct. So some clarification has been given under Ind AS 10. Ki any financial statement which are to be approved by shareholders after financial statement are approved by board of directors. Means it might happen approval of shareholders is required. After approval of what? Board of director. Then also the date of approval will be when the financial statement are approved by board of directors. Similarly, when financial statement are to be approved by supervisory board of non-executive director after management has approved it. For example, bank has appointed some officer of their person as a supervisory board if the entity has taken loan. So after management has given approval, it need to be approved by that supervisory board. But can that approval by supervisory board is not relevant, will take which date of approval by board of directors. Correct. Any financial statement approved by board of director after public announcement of profit or other financial information, that is also not relevant. Even the profit has been announced, but will take which date of approval by board of directors. Correct. Understood. Now in this, what are the two types of event? Adjusting event, non-adjusting event. Correct. So what are adjusting event? Which provide further evidence of what? Condition existing on balance sheet date or reporting date. So any event which provide further evidence of the condition which is existing on balance sheet date is known as adjusting event, and that need to be adjusted to financial statement. When I say adjusted to financial statement, means can I say income or expense should be adjusted and assets or liability need to be adjusted. Correct. Understood. So what are non-adjusting event? Any event which relate to any condition arising after reporting date. Any event which relate to condition arising after reporting date, then it will be non-adjusting event and no adjustment is required. But a disclosure is required in what? Financial statement, that is notes to account. Means AS4 says disclosures are required in the report of approving authority. Ind AS 10 says disclosures are required where? In financial statement. If the amount is immaterial, means if amount is immaterial, we can ignore the disclosure due to which concept? Materiality concept, correct? Now, there are some examples of adjusting event. Examples, for example, the settlement of court case after reporting period. Settlement of court case after reporting period. For example, bankruptcy of customer that occur after reporting period. Any debtor become insolvent may give rise to a what? Evidence of the condition existing on balance sheet date. A sale of inventory after reporting period may give guidance or may give evidence about NRV. Already we have done under Ind AS 2 also, ki sale of inventory will give an evidence of NRV on reporting date. NRV on reporting date, correct? The determination after reporting period of the amount of profit sharing or bonus payment means, can I say, profit is known only after reporting date, but on that profit some bonus is payable to employee. So even though it occur after reporting date, means profit is known after reporting date, but there was a condition on balance sheet date for payment of what? Bonus. For payment of bonus, therefore this will be also what? Adjusting event, correct? The discovery of fraud or error, discovery of any fraud or error after balance sheet date but before approval will be also what? Adjusting event, correct? Understood. So these are some examples of adjusting event. Some examples of non-adjusting event: decline in market value of investment. The decline in market value investment is not a adjusting event, correct? Major business combination, any amalgamation, etc. after reporting date are not adjusting event, correct? Announcement of plan to discontinue an operation. We have done restructuring in case of Ind AS 37. What Ind AS 37 says, ki restructuring cost will be provided when there is a constructive obligation on reporting date, and when constructive obligation arises, when there is a detailed formal plan and that plan has been announced on which date? On reporting date or before reporting date. Means if plan has been announced after reporting date, whether there is any constructive obligation on reporting date? No, Baba, no. Therefore, it become what? Non-adjusting event, correct? Then major purchase of asset. Major purchase of asset does not give rise to any condition existing on balance sheet date, correct? Then classification of asset as held for sale after reporting date means any property, plant and equipment, any intangible asset which are classified as held for sale, means which become held for sale after reporting date, does not give rise to any condition existing on balance sheet date, correct? But for this detailed discussion will be done under Ind AS 105. Then changes in forex rate, changes in foreign exchange rate does not give rise to any condition existing on balance sheet date. Major litigation after reporting date, any litigation which arise after reporting date is not a adjusting event, correct? These are the few examples. Then we have done some special case. First was long term loan, correct? So in this long term loan, what we have done, ki whenever there is a breach of contract of any material provision in case of long term borrowing on or before reporting date, means there is a breach of contract of some material provision of long term borrowing before reporting date or on reporting date, and because of that reason, because of that breach, the long term borrowing become payable on demand, and with that effect such loan become payable on demand. So can I say it become current liability on reporting date? It is payable on demand, it become current liability on reporting date. So what Ind AS 10 says, if such loan will be classified as NCL. NCL means non-current liability, means even though it become current liability on reporting date, such loan will be classified as non-current liability if lender agreed not to demand payment before what? Approval of financial statement for issue. Means if lender has decided not to demand payment, then it will be what? It will be considered as what? Adjusting event, non-adjusting event. adjusting now, current liability will become what? Non-current liability. It will be considered as adjusting event. But in this, there is one carve out. Means what IAS 10 says, as per IAS 10, it will be a non-adjusting event. Means even though lender has agreed not to demand payment, but it will be classified as what? Current liability. It will be classified as current liability internationally, not in India. In India, it will be what? Non-current liability. Internationally, it will be what? Current liability. Understood this point? Correct. Then I have given one chart for this. Ki long-term borrowing breach of contract, if it is a minor defect, minor default, then it will be what? Considered as non-current liability only. Man, if it is a minor default, then bank will never demand. Bank will never demand, means it will be classified as non-current only. But if it become major default, major defect, material provision has been what? Not fulfilled. Then if lender agree not to demand before approval account, then it will remain as what? Non-current liability. In other situation, it will be considered as current liability. Correct? Understood this point? Then we have done going concern. Going concern. An entity shall not prepare financial statement based on what? Going concern. An entity will not prepare financial statement based on going concern if it intend to liquidate or ceases trading. Intend to liquidate means still not liquidated. They have decided to liquidate in near future. Or ceases trading, but till now not liquidated. I have stopped doing what? I have stopped teaching you, but it does not mean I will not teach you. But ceases trading, correct? And has no realistic alternative but to liquidate. And there are no other option, but only one option is available to liquidate. Correct? For example, if syllabus change, so I might be having no other option but to stop teaching only. Correct? So if entity going concern assumption is affected, then financial statement is not prepared as per going concern. Correct? So what they say is, if going concern assumption is not appropriate, then it become invalid after reporting date. Ind AS 10 require fundamental change in the basis of accounting rather than adjustment toward financial statement. What they are saying, if the going concern is affected after reporting date, even though it is non-adjusting event, because there was no condition existing on balance sheet date about that non-going concern, correct? But even though it will be considered as adjusting event, but only adjustment is not required, entire financial statement will be prepared by fundamental change in the basis of accounting. When we say fundamental change in the basis of accounting, it means all assets and liability will be recognized at now NRV, net realizable value. Net realizable value. Correct? Understood? Then, as per Ind AS 10 says what is required, fundamental change in the basis of accounting is required. Ind AS 1 says whenever going concern assumption is affected, then you should disclose some what information. First, the fact. Second, basis of preparing financial statement. Third, reason why entity is not regarded as going concern. Fact means you need to state that now we are a non-going concern entity. Then we need to also disclose the basis of preparing financial statement. Then we should also disclose reason why you are not regarded as going concern. Correct? Okay. Means, can I say, if there is an event after reporting date, and if due to that event, going concern remain valid, means fire occurred and going concern remain valid, so batao, it is an adjusting or non-adjusting? It is a non-adjusting event, then no adjustment required. Only a disclosure is required if the amount is material. Understood? Correct? This point. And if going concern is not valid, a fundamental change in the basis of accounting is required. means only adjustment is not required. Entire financial statement now will be prepared based on some different basis of accounting. Correct this you. And disclosure are required as per Ind AS 1. Then proposed dividend. So now I think you have understood there is no accounting treatment of proposed dividend because of Ind AS 10 as well as AS 4. So what this is, if entity declared dividend to the equity shareholder, equity shareholders, not to the holder of equity instrument, to the holder of equity instrument. So if entity declared dividend to the holder of equity instrument after reporting date, then entity shall not recognize it as a liability on reporting date. Means it will not be recognized in current financial statement. It will recognize in the next financial statement when it is paid, when it is declared or paid. Understood? Correct? Okay. However, such dividend are disclosed in notes to account, in notes, in accordance with Ind AS 1 and as per the requirement of Schedule 3. So what Ind AS 1 says, we should disclose if any dividend is declared after reporting date. So we will not recognize it, but we will disclose the fact as a what? Disclosure, as a disclosure. Correct? Understood? Now I think you understood, because now we know financial instrument chapter, redeemable preference shares are not equity instrument. So any dividend or redeemable preference shares will not be recognized as per EIR, effective interest rate. You remember? Correct? So now redeemable preference shares are not equity participant, equity instrument. Correct? Correct. Then one special point we have done, distribution of non-cash asset to the owner. Owner means holder of equity instrument, non-cash asset. Non-cash asset means, everyone, just try to understand. He suppose this is what? Entity. And this is what? Equity share holders. Correct? So if entity is declaring dividend in cash, dividend in cash, then accounting treatment will be as per Ind AS 32. Correct? Understood? But if entity is distributing any non-cash asset or non-cash asset plus cash. Correct? Means an option has been given that either you can take non-cash asset or cash. Then accounting treatment is given where? In Appendix A to Ind AS 10. Ind AS 10. Okay. Now, what Ind AS 10 says? On the date of proposal, no journal entry. So on the date of proposal, no journal entry. Why? Because no liability has been occurred. On the date of proposal, no liability will be recognized. Correct? Okay. Then, On the date of declaration, means when such dividend is declared, or I say approved, correct? So once that dividend which is distributed in the form of non-cash asset is either declared or approved, then will create a liability. And the journal entry what? Retained earning, account debit to dividend payable. And this journal entry be done with the amount of fair value of non-cash asset. Fair value of non-cash asset. Okay? On the reporting date, means suppose कि बिफोर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन रिपोर्टिंग डेट कम तो दिस डिविडेंड पेएबल विल बी रीअसेस्ड विल बी रीअसेस्ड एज पर व्हाट एज पर करंट फेयर वैल्यू ऑफ नॉन कैश एसेट नॉन कैश एसेट अर्बिंग व्हाट आई एम सेइंग नॉन कैश एसेट means if the fair value of asset decreases then we pass the journal entry dividend payable to retained earning if it increases then retained earning to dividend payable theek hai then on settlement date we'll pass one journal entry dividend payable account debit to what asset can I say this will come at what fair value This will come at carrying amount, and any difference will be recognized where? In PL. Any difference will be recognized in PL. Means any difference in dividend payable amount and the carrying amount of non-cash asset will be recognized through PL. This guidance has been given under where? Appendix A to Ind AS 10. Means in exam don't write as per Ind AS 10. In exam write down. As per appendix A to Ind AS 10, correct? Now, थोड़ा सा if I say non cash asset, correct? If I say non cash asset, तो it can be either inventory, or it can be what? Other than inventory, or I can write on property, plant and equipment. It can be investment property. It can be intangible asset. So whenever non-cash asset is proposed to be distributed, it is known as held for distribution. Held for distribution to owner. So once it is proposed, it means now it become held for distribution to the owner. Now, if it is held for distribution to owner, to find out carrying amount of inventory, will apply Ind AS 2. Means it will be measured on reporting date as per what cost price or NRV, whichever is lower, as per Ind AS 2. But for PP etc., which Ind AS will be applicable? Ind AS 105 will be applicable. Ind AS 105 will be applicable. So once it is held for distribution to owner, then respective Ind AS will be seized. Means for PP will not apply Ind AS 16. For intangible asset will not apply Ind AS 38. Are you getting what I am saying? Then we'll come to which Ind AS? Ind AS 105. And Ind AS 105 says now it will be measured at carrying amount or fair value less cost to sell, whichever is lower. And from this date, depreciation will be seized. Means now no depreciation will be charged. Are you getting what I am saying? Correct? Understood? So once property, plant and equipment, intangible assets, etc. are held for distribution to owner, which Ind AS is applicable? Ind AS 105 is applicable. But Ind AS 105 says it will be valued at lower of carrying amount or fair value less cost to sell. And from this date will be seized, depreciation will be seized. Okay, detailed discussion will be done under which Ind AS? Ind AS 105. I think you have understood this point. Correct? Correct. Understood? Then disclosure requirement. So disclosure requirement are what? Ki date of approval should be given. What is the date of approval? Who gave approval? The name of the person is required. And if any owner, any entity's owner, or any other person who have power to amend the financial statement after approval, the name of that person is also required. Sometimes some power has been given to the entity owner that they can amend the financial statement after approval of board of director. If such a power has been given through articles by association, then such person name is also required. Correct? Then Any updating disclosure about condition existing on balance sheet date is also required. Okay? Then for non-adjusting event, if the amount is material, nature of the event and estimate of financial effects should be disclosed. However, if it cannot be estimated, the fact must be disclosed. Correct? Very simple. What are difference? Ind AS 10, AS 4. First difference, non-adjusting event. Disclosure in financial statement. Disclosure in the report of approving authority. Okay. Then going concern. Ind AS 10 require a fundamental change in the basis of accounting if going concern become inappropriate. However, AS 4 only say require adjustment to assets and liability. Even though this point is a theoretical difference, but practically, as per AS 4, also we used to redraft as per what? Fundamental change in the basis of accounting. But it will be a theoretical difference, correct? Disclosure, of course, more where in Ind AS 10, less in AS 4. Means AS 4 does not require this disclosure. Point number A was not required under AS 4, correct? Then, distribution of non-cash asset deals silent. AS 4 is silent. Understood? Correct? So this is what? Ind AS 10. Very simple.